And you know, another aspect, you know, once this is complete and you are in service, then more channels start opening up. And now, you know, maybe half of the audience who is listening to this video will be like, okay, now you're losing me. It's like, once we start talking about evolution that goes beyond the planet Earth, you know, we start talking about angelic forces, we start talking about things that some people will be like, oh, I'm not sure if I believe really in all that, you know. But it's like, the next step is to start talking about galactic consciousness and things like galactic federation and the galactic core and source of energy which are there, you know, Sirius and Pleiades. What? Alien life forms? You know, supernatural beings that come and visit the planet Earth? Now we are like, okay, is this part of our consciousness? Is this something that we can take or not? In my system, in my belief, gods and goddesses are real, you know, they are like, yeah, they are supernatural, magnificent, incredibly powerful beings that come and visit the Earth. You know, they have an impact. The Sun, which is the center of our solar system, is an intelligent being that has, you know, that not in the human sense, but a consciousness that reaches really, really, really far away. We have stars that are thousands of light years away that are having an impact on planet Earth right now. We see the light. We even perceive something physical out of them. What about their energy body, you know, reaching out? So now we are, you see that we went from personal evolution to having a good impact on planet Earth. Now we are talking about galactic evolution as a human race. And that's like, that's cosmology. That's like what I call galactivation. And once we enter into that, then it's no longer about, you know, the small stories about our life. It's like the big story. It's like creating energetic spaceships to get ready for space travel, you know. And that starts becoming really, really interesting because, you know, you say, well, that's nice fairy tale stories, but what if you physically, emotionally, energetically experience it in the core of your being? Like, you really feel, you start feeling how it works. You know, did you hear about the Merkaba, right? The angelic vehicle? What is it? Why is it a concept? Why is it that we develop an angelic vehicle? For what? The energy body can suddenly take us into travel? Why do we talk about out-of-body experiences? Why is this part of our consciousness? Why do we talk about meridians? What's this thing about the energy body? How does a supernatural experience feel like? So, optimization, service, and then we enter into the next stages of the future of our human evolution. You will notice that when we start talking about that, instead of looking back into the past and talking about religious traditions and all that stuff, we talk about the future of our evolution. And there are places right now where this future is being manifested. You go, you go to places like Burning Man in California, it's like, it's not from this planet. You see what's happening there and you go like, what's going on here? This feels so surreal. And instead of looking into the past, like you would look into the past if you go to an Indian temple or you go to an ancient monastery somewhere in the Sinai desert, there we are talking about something else. We're talking about taking our whole consciousness and saying, instead of saying, my past is my life, you say, no, my future is my life. And then you open your radiance towards the future and you say, wow, this is pulling me forward. It's like making me access stuff that is not even part of my consciousness yet. Not in my past, not part of human consciousness. It feels like we are downloading or receiving messages or receiving codes that are not yet manifested on planet Earth. And this is like, wow, you know, then we are really talking about something that puts us into this kind of, you know, Jedi mindset where you feel like there is something highly supernatural happening. And so it's difficult to function on that level if you are dealing with a breakup. You know, because a breakup is still a heartbreak. You know, respectfully, a heartbreak is still the small stories. It's still like life, you know, oh, I wanted a relationship and it was my romantic dream and this girl or that guy doesn't like me and therefore I'm going through a heartbreak, and then you spend like 10 years going through therapy and dealing with that cycle of emotion. It's like, no, we need, you know, I mean, it's interesting and it's part of your evolution to go through something like that. And while you are doing that, it's very hard for you to focus on the big picture, because you are obsessed with what somebody in your past used to give you. Or you're obsessed with receiving the love from somebody physical, when in fact the universe is really ready to bombard you with unlimited love and unlimited source of energy coming from all over the place. And so those small stories, first we need to learn how to harmonize that. Because if you and I are in a spaceship, you know, with a tribe of 50 people, we are not going to talk to take the small stories of our childhood into this space travel. We're not. You know, we first, as a human race, we need to get that together. Whoever or whatever force are sponsoring our galactic evolution are not going to allow us to enter into this galactic grid and say, oh yeah, great, you human beings, start building some atomic bombs and bring it out there to other planets to fuck it up. No! First get it together. We give you some dimension of power, you learn how to master that, and then we give you a bit more power, and then we give you a bit more power. And then once you realize that using that power to auto-destroy each other is not a good idea, then we give you even more power. But if somebody comes and gives you power, you know, and you turn that into a weapon, it's like, sorry, didn't pass the test. Back to a laboratory, we're going to give you another form of power and see if you can use that to help each other. And then, because as a human race, we need each other. If we were investing even a fraction, maybe 10% of what is used around the world for weapons, you would eradicate poverty around the planet. Imagine how incredible messed up we are as a human race, where all that is still missing. We are not yet optimizing. So this is why right now we are not yet getting the green light to go into space and full-on space exploration, because there are forces out there which say we don't want to interact with these energies because they are too challenging, too much shadow yet. The animal nature is still dominating humankind, and so you need to optimize all that and find cycles and ways of doing that that is not going to mess up the inner levels once you get access to them. And so there is a certain order or harmony, and we are allowed to impact on a certain sphere. And right now, well, look at what we are doing with nature, for instance. It's not harmonious. We need first to be like, okay, these are beings. How can we respect that? And how can we build a very harmonious relationship as a human race towards the animal races? And then, you know, so that we can synchronize our evolution. And what I do with Vital Tantra and Vital Coaching is really giving you tools to harmonize all that. You know, find ways of communicating. How do you relate to nature? How do you relate to your mother? Mother is sacred. Motherhood is like, we must love our mothers, our fathers. We must love our ancestors. We must love our nature around us. We must love each other. If you have a fight with somebody or a disagreement, looks like we disagree, we have a different opinion on something. It doesn't mean that I have to kill you or attack you or challenge you. No, it's like, we have a different opinion, I respect you. That's it, solved. What about, you know, different religious systems and different beliefs and so on? It's like, we are a vast, diverse human race with lots of different things, but we need to learn how to synchronize all that and live together, so that once we find ourselves on some form of galactic spaceship together with 10,000 other people, you know, we can create a sphere there which is a harmonious space of consciousness, that we can go and populate other planets with our human seeds and our consciousness. You know, there is a big story behind that. I mean, that's my belief, you know. Maybe I lost you about half an hour ago now in this whole story. But, you know, it's a form of consciousness that is emerging a lot. And nowadays, when you ask somebody, where do you come from? Very often the answer is like, Orion, Pleiades, I come from Sirius, you know, some part in the faraway galaxy there, you know, I don't know exactly where, you know. So it's kind of emerging in our consciousness more and more nowadays. And people are more and more aware also that aliens are not necessarily traveling in a physical spaceship, you know. It's like, it's multidimensional. It's something which is much more subtle that has to do with transfers of consciousness and stuff like that. There is much more to say about that one. Like, you launched me on this and honestly, it's all intuitive research. So when we talk about things like that, it's no longer science. You know, science can back up a little bit, give you some elements, but it's mainly like impression that you get from within. This is like, it's intuitive research. We're no longer talking about something that is rational. Yeah. Beautiful. Pagi, pagi. Something we do when we practice anything here, at the end we just raise our hands to the sky and go like, Jaya, 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 Jaya. Jaya means victory. Hope you have a good time and I'll see you soon again.